Coming up in our next segment, everyone's favorite, tarot card readings by yours truly. You're listening to Mystic Fix on NewsTalk STL 101.9 and 94.1.
Our spiritual journey tonight will begin.
Can't outrun your fate.
Let me tell you about you.
I know who you are, what you are, and why you have come.
Take a good look at these cards, young man. They contain all the secrets of the universe.
What does it say?
And we're back with Mystic Fix. It's time for the tarot card readings for our lucky callers.
Hello.
Hi, is this Davida?
It is.
Hello, this is Julia from Mystic Fix.
Hi.
What's your question for us today?
I had falls that made me have quite a bit of surgery on my bones. And I really would like to know how that looks. Well, I'm trying to recuperate.
Okay.
How that will go for me.
Okay, sure. Let me take a look. And I do have another psychic here with me. Do you want to also do a reading, Harmony?
Yeah.
So, all right. So, Davida, I'm putting your cards down now. Okay. So, honestly, this does look like a time of good healing for you. I am not too worried. Your first card is Ace of Cups, and this is a handing to you of, you know, sometimes medicine. Cups are always about healing. So you are on the path for healing. Now, the Seven of Pentacles, the Seven of Pentacles is the time. That is the unfortunate circumstance here. This isn't a fast healing. It looks like it's going to take a little while. It's the man who has sown his seeds and he's waiting to reap the rewards. But, you know, that can be the next season. So your central card, Davida, is Judgment. And the Judgment card is our karma card. And karma is not good things happen to good people and bad things happen to bad people. We all know that's not true. It's more like in the Bible where we say, as you sow, so you shall reap. And what we sow are seeds. So the way I'm seeing this, there's a lesson for you in why this fall happened to you. You may have been doing something from negative energy, basically. And what I mean by that is if you, you know, if I tell you, Davida, I want you to come over and clean my basement for me. Okay. Well, that's a big imposition, right? But if you go, okay, I'll do it, and you come over grumbling and you do it, well, that might be an occasion that you have a fall. Your energy would be bad. It wouldn't be a true, authentic expression of joy, right? And we're here to be honest and joyful. So if you do something from anger, if you do something from guilt, if you do something because you're forced to, it usually does not pan out. So I would really like to see you in a place of sort of checking in on that inner emotion and how do I really feel about this? And sometimes we don't know always in the moment, and don't make a decision from a place where you don't know your energy. Take a moment. Now, your next card is the Star, and this is about a dream coming true. So I do believe you're going to be healed, but there is a caveat here, and it's the Page of Cups, and it does look like you're continuing to take some medicine or some therapy. So it may be that, you know, you continue to have some aches and pains and need a little bit of help with that. But overall, I do see you healing. So, Harmony, is there something you'd like to say about this?
So one of the things I see that's coming through with this is taking a look within your emotions and that what emotions were you experienced at the time you had the fall? And then also, like, what emotions, how does those emotions link to something in your past and especially in past relationships? And then how does that relate to the relationships you're in right now? Because it looks like you're being tested in this karma to really come into the like connection of your own emotions, and you're to be filling up your own cup instead of doing people pleasing with other people.
Okay.
So that's really not so different.
It is a lot.
Yeah. So thank you so much. And I hope that's helpful. And I think, you know, if you can just have one takeaway, you're going to be all right. You're going to be better soon. It's just going to take a little while. You bet. Nice talking to you. Take care.
Thank you so much.
Bye-bye.
This is Anna.
Hello, Anna. This is Julia from Mystic Fix. How you doing?
I'm good, Julia. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Thank you. I have Dr. Harmony in the station with me today. She is a fellow psychic, and so you are going to get a double reading. So what is your question, please? Yeah.
Yes. Well, as you know, I'm an Akashic reader, and I'm very familiar with energy and working with energy, but I have been absolutely just inundated with massive amounts of energy, almost to the point where I'm debilitated this week since Tuesday. And I would love to know what the heck is going on and what I can do about it.
Okay. Hang tight. We are shuffling the cards. Harmony is going to start, and then I'll jump in with mine.
Just so you know, these cards are very magnetic.
Oh.
I can feel them. Interesting. Okay. So one of the first things I want to start with, based on what you said about the energy, is you definitely are going through a process of upgrading your and awakening your soul blueprint. And so you're shifting away from definitely an identity of your past. And so you may be finding or feeling, if it hasn't even started, like everything around you, because this upgrade in your energy is going to start shifting away from you. And the problem is, though, you have not been willing to receive. And so you're being asked in this upgrade to open up and to be able to shift your cups around, basically, because we got a lot of cups going on here in the reading that we have. And so it's like, as anything's coming into you, it's also going away from you. So I feel like that's connected to also like a relationship, and that is within you. And we just had a talk about this, but so shifting from like your ability to show up in a way that you start to pay attention to what your needs are and becoming like the star. So the star is a card here that also is about you activating your light and becoming more of your higher self and becoming an illuminating light for those around you, which you've been. But you need to step forward into coming into your feminine energy, because your feminine energy is out of balance with your masculine energy. And again, you need to learn to receive.
All right. Now I will read for you, Anna. All right. So, yeah, we got some, I mean, it's showing up for me as sort of blockages. Your first card is the Seven of Cups, and this is about your goals, your bucket list, which you look to me like you have a lot of clear things in mind. You have a lot of decisions about your direction and where you're putting your energy already. But it isn't a card of fruition necessarily. Ace of Wands is next for you, and this is about ideas and enthusiasm. You know, you've got all of that in spades, but your central card is the Hanged Man in reverse. And I like to say the Hanged Man hangs from his foot, not his neck. He's not dying. And he's also got this halo around his head, which is enlightenment. He's learning in his stuckness. I think this whacked out energy you're feeling is your enlightenment. Mm-hmm. And so it's interesting because you've got the Five of Wands in reverse, which is a self-struggle. Straight up, the Five of Wands is struggle with others, but in reverse, I read that as within the self. So, you know, you may be trying to tame this energy. You may be trying to apply it to those dreams in the Seven of Cups. You may have, specific ways you want to handle yourself in this energy. And I feel like the cards are like, you can't necessarily control this. So I do see it sort of settling down. We've got the Seven of Pentacles, which is a card of taking some time. It is a card of reaping the rewards after a certain amount of time. So I don't think this is necessarily bad, but I would say don't fight it. And try to go with the flow as much as you can.
Okay.
All right. Thank you so much, Anna.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Hello.
Amanda, this is Julia from Mystic Fix.
How are you?
Hi. Very well, thank you. Do you have a question for me?
Yeah, I do. I'm thinking about changing jobs.
Okay. And all right, and I have a fellow psychic beside me. We're both going to read you. You get a double reading today. So you just want me to look at the job change and see what I see?
Yeah.
Okay.
I would have thought of a better question if I know.
It's good. Well, I see it happening. So Ace of Wands is a new beginning, and it's energetic and enthusiastic. The Judgment card is saying it's about being rewarded for hard work. You know, you can't get a better card in a career question. So, you have the experience, you have the ability. Your central card, Nine of Cups in reverse, you're just not very satisfied where you are now. And the Three of Pentacles is in reverse, which is letting go of a contract or a commitment. So I see you celebrating this job change with the Three of Cups at the end. It's simply going to happen, and it looks like sooner rather than later. I will let my friend Harmony take over from here and fill in some of the details.
Nice.
Nice to meet you.
Hi. Do you see any, like, particular direction I should be looking in?
Well, first of all, a piece of this is about letting go of the past and, like, your past stories, your experiences, the pain that's related to this, or basically even your fear. And it also feels like there's a little bit of concern about what if you've got the right tools, the skills that you need. But you have the Queen of Swords that is, like, in this present moment, that who you are and where you are, and it's the central point of this process. And so the Queen knows what she wants. So you need to be very decisive. You need to, like, basically make a choice and choose that this is the direction you want to go forward, because hanging on to the past is what's going to slow the process down. So in this process, definitely there's a celebration. And it's really, like, in the past aspect, we have, like, the Nine of Swords here. So it's really cutting ties to your old patterns. So it's going to get you moving forward, moving into the Five of Pentacles, which really also connects to magic and creation and the alchemist. And it's what do you want? So choose what you want. Stay focused on that. And then, you know, that's the block, is you making the decision to come within yourself and to choose your direction and bring your power into it.
I never got a college education, and it's always been a source of, you know, I've done well without it, but it has always been like a little back in my mind, I should have, you know, or I can't apply for this because it, you know, I don't have that degree behind me. So,
yeah, I wouldn't let that slow you down. In this day and age, especially as someone who comes out of academia, which I do, there so many degrees are just kind of bought and paid for, and they do not equate real world experience. Mm-hmm. So your maturity, is something that the right employer will value. So don't degrade yourself. Don't look down on yourself for that. I think you are going to be celebrating from where I saw. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you, Amanda. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Before we go, I want to thank our sponsor, CommaFlight, at the Cho Zen Retreat Center in Sebastian, Florida. Redefining the dance between the masculine and the feminine. Visit at CommaFlight, that's CammaFlight, on Instagram for videos, links, and more information. Well, that's another episode of Mystic Fix. If you enjoyed this, please like and subscribe to the podcast or videocast. Subscriptions are the way we get found in searches, and it really helps. You're listening to Mystic Fix on 101.9 and 94.1 News Talk STL. Until next time.